Hello students, welcome for today's session. In today's session, we are going to study about HTML symbols. So symbols means there are sometimes some symbols that are not present on your keyboard, but you can add those symbols by using entities. So HTML has some predefined entities using which you can display particular symbols on your screen. So many mathematical, technical and currency symbols, they are not present on your keyboard. So to add such symbols to an HTML page, what we can do is we can use the entity name or we can use the entity number, which is a decimal or a hexadecimal reference for the symbol. So we can use anything. We can use either the number of the entity or the name of the entity. So you can refer to a full set of symbols that are available. Alright, entire name as well as the number is available. So depending on which symbol you want to use, you can use. So now we will start with the program. Go to Notepad. Document type HTML, root element HTML, then the head tag, the title tag. Title, I'm going to give the title as HTML symbols. Okay, so this is the title that I have given, HTML symbols. Then I'm going to close the head tag and then start with the body tag. Now in body tag, I'm going to display the euro. Okay, euro, you know, right? European currency. So that euro I'm going to display. So I'm going to write paragraph. I will display euro. Okay. And then I will write it as ampersand euro, semicolon, close the paragraph. Because it is an entity, it should end with a semicolon. Okay, then I'm going to display euro in by using the hexadecimal numbers, decimal as well as hexadecimal numbers. So I will display entity, so this ampersand symbol should come, hash, and then 8364. So this is a decimal number. Then I will do the same thing using hexadecimal. So I will write it as ampersand x2 20 8, and then I close the paragraph element. I close the body tag followed by the HTML tag. I will click on save. I will save this as HTML symbols.html. All files. Okay. Yes. Where is my file? Okay. This is my file. Right click and I say Google Chrome. So now did you observe? I will display euro and then the euro symbol is displayed. I will zoom in a bit so that you will understand. Okay, so now what has happened? This symbol is not present on my keyboard, but still I am able to display the symbol. I have used the entity name, I have used the entity number in terms of decimal as well as in terms of hexadecimal. Okay, now we will do some changes. Now you all must have played cards. Okay, so you have certain symbols, right, for the cards. So I will write it as, I will display spades. Okay, then I will display hearts. Now I want to display clubs. Okay, this I will put it into a bold so that is visible very clearly. Bold. Okay, and then I click on save. I click on refresh. Now did you observe the output? The first one is the spade symbol that you find in your cards. Then you have the heart symbol. You also have the club symbol. Okay, so what is happening? These symbols are actually not present on your keyboard so that you can type them. But what I have done, I have used the entity name and then I have displayed them. Alright. Now, if you want some mathematical related symbol, I will display product. Ampersand. Product. Okay, now if I want to display the sum, I will display sum. Okay, I will save this. So this is, do you find this symbol on the keyboard? You don't find these symbols on the keyboard. This is for the summation. So what happens, you have different equations which require the summation symbol. So in all such situations, you can use this summation symbol. And you also have the product, your science equation or your math equations usually have this symbol. Alright, so what is going to happen if you use directly, you cannot type them, you can use the entity name. Okay, you have one exist empty. Okay, these are the symbols for the set. Exist, I write it here as empty. Click on refresh. So now what happened? Did you observe? This is the sets exist symbol. We say that this element exists within this or belongs to set A or set B. Okay. What you can do is, I will write it in this manner. A, B. Now, did you all understand how it has come? Okay, so how this symbol is showing? So we can use the symbols when we have certain like entities to be displayed. So did you observe now? It has changed. A, the set exists in B. B is an empty set. Alright. So in this manner, why it was wrong? Because we have to give a semicolon immediately after the entity. That's why it was not being displayed. You have A is not in B. If you want to use that, is in. Okay. And then A is not in. Okay, I'm going to save this file. Click on refresh. Just a minute. ampersand A is not in T. So you can observe here that symbol is visible. Alright. So this is how we can use the different HTML symbols. Okay. For finding the symbols that are not present on the keyboard. So we'll continue in the next session. Thank you, students.